गुड मॉर्निंग टू एवरी वन, वेलकम बैक टू आवर चैनल एन सी आर टी धमाका 98। टुडे वी आर टेकिंग दी 16 चैप्टर इलेक्ट्रिक करंट एंड सिंपल सर्किट्स। इट इज़ अ चैप्टर ऑफ द 7th क्लास सब्जेक्ट साइंस। नाउ गाइस वी आर गोइंग टू लर्न अबाउट दिस चैप्टर। दैट फर्स्ट ऑफ ऑल गाइस आई वॉन्ट टू शेयर दैट दीज आर द पॉइंट्स दैट विच वी आर गोइंग टू लर्न इन दिस चैप्टर। दीज आर द टॉपिक्स लाइक फर्स्ट टॉपिक इज फ्लो ऑफ इलेक्ट्रिक करंट, सेकेंड टॉपिक इलेक्ट्रिक सर्किट एंड फंक्शंस ऑफ ईच कंपोनेंट ऑफ द सर्किट, थर्ड पॉइंट इफेक्ट ऑफ करंट एंड फोर्थ टॉपिक वर्किंग ऑफ इलेक्ट्रोमैग्नेट्स एंड लास्ट पॉइंट विच वी लर्न इन दिस चैप्टर और टॉपिक वर्किंग ऑफ रेन इलेक्ट्रिक बेल। नाउ वी हैव डिस्कस्ड द टॉपिक्स। नाउ फर्स्ट ऑफ ऑल वी हैव टू कंप्लीट आवर स्टेपिंग स्टोन्स। Now, electricity plays an important role in our life. Guys, as we know that the electricity, it is very important in our life. It plays a very important in our life for any purpose and in our life. And without that electricity, we can't do such type of the things. It illuminates our houses and streets. Now, what's electricity? It also illuminates our houses and the streets. Without the electricity, our houses or streets cannot be looking like good. It is used to run elevators and machines. Now guys, this electricity, it is also used to run the elevators and the machines. Wide ranges of electrical phenomenon are observed in different forms. Now guys, the ranges of the electrical phenomenon, they are observed in the different forms. From lightning in the sky to glowing bulb, electricity is around us. Now guys, from the lightning in the sky to glowing bulb, electricity is around us. Write the 5 uses of electricity to mankind. Now guys, you have to tell me that the 5 uses of the electricity in our daily life or the human life. Now let's move to the topics. It is the first topic, electric current. The amount of electricity held or carried by something is called electric charge. Now guys, what is electric charge? Means that the amount of electricity which is held or the carried by the something, that something is called the electrical charge. There are 2 types of electric charges. Now guys, there are two types of the electric charges, positive and negative. So these are the 2 types of the electric charges. First is positive and second is negative. They are carried by the electrons and protons. So now why these electric charges, positive and negative, these are carried by the electrons and the protons. Electrons are said to be carry negative charge, while protons are said to be carry positive charge. So now why is the electrons? The electrons, they are said to be the carry the negative charge. The electrons are said to carry the negative charge, and the protons, these protons, they carry the positive charge. When there is a flow of electrically charges through a conductor, it is termed as electric current. So now guys, when there is a flow of electric charges through the conductor, so it is termed as the electric current. Now the SI unit of current is ampere. So it is very important line. The SI unit of current is ampere. Now next topic, electric circuit. The arrangement through which an electric current flows in a conductor when it is connected to a source of electricity is known as electric करंट, इलेक्ट्रिक सर्किट, सुना होगा इस इलेक्ट्रिक सर्किट, वी ऑल हैव इलेक्ट्रिक सर्किट इन आवर होम। सो वॉट इज इलेक्ट्रिक सर्किट? इलेक्ट्रिक सर्किट मीन्स इट इज़ द अरेंजमेंट, इट इज़ द अरेंजमेंट बाई विच द इलेक्ट्रिक करंट्स फ्लोस इन द कंडक्टर when the conductor it is connected to the source of the electricity is known as the electric circuit. A simple circuit consists of, now I think, first point, a source of electric current, cell or a battery. Now what is the electric circuit? These are consist of many things, many source. So the source of the electric current is that cell or a battery. Second, conducting material such as a metal wire. And second thing, the contained by the electric current is the metal wire or the cell or a battery. Now let's move to the next page. Now we are on the next page. A switch to make or break the circuit. A bulb to show the globe current. Now as for making the electric circuit, we need a switch. So what is the role of the switch? It is used to make or break the circuit. And a bulb. Next we need bulb. So what is bulb? It show the flow of the current. Now we made a simple electric circuit by using a cell, a wire and a bulb. It means guys that we can make a simple circuit by using the cell, wire or a bulb. With the help of the sources, we can simply made a electric circuit. When the circuit is closed, the bulb glows. So it's when the circuit is closed, so our bulb is glows. If the circuit is not closed, then the bulb will not glow. So if the circuit it is not closed, then the bulb will not glow. For example, if the metal wire is broken, replaced with a rubber band, non-conductor or the cell is not connected, double bulb will not glow. So guys, for example, if a metal wire is broken, so it replaced with the rubber band or a non-conductor or the cell is not connected, so the bulb will not glow. A circuit is also provided with a switch that makes it possible to allow or stop the flow of current. Now why the circuit? Our circuit, it is also provide the switch that is used to make the possible for allowing the stop of flowing of the current. When the switch is off, the circuit is broken and the current doesn't flow through it. So it's when our switch is off, so the circuit is broken and the current doesn't flow through it. Such a circuit is called the open circuit. Now guys, here you can see it is open circuit and it is a closed circuit. Here you can see it is a closed circuit and it is a open circuit. In this circuit the current will not flow, and in this circuit the current will flow because it is the closed circuit. So when the switch is on, the circuit is closed, the current will flow through it. Such circuit is called the closed circuit. So guys, what is a closed circuit means? When our switch is on, when the switch is on and the circuit is closed, so the current will flow through it. And this type of the circuit is called the closed circuit. Every circuit consists of a source of electricity. There are several sources of electricity. Now is each and every circuit it consists of the source of the electricity, and there are many sources of the electricity. It can be generated from moving wind, flowing water, sunlight or even manure that are obtained from the animal waste. So guys, it can also be the generated from the moving wind, flowing of the water, sunlight or even the manure that are obtained from the animal waste. And these are the sources of the electricity. Now next topic. अगर फर्स्ट ऑफ ऑल आई वॉन्ट टू शेयर द बंडर बॉक्स. वोल्टेज प्रोवाइडेड बाय वन सेल इज 1.5 वोल्टेज एंड वोल्टेज प्रोवाइडेड बाय अ बैटरी हैविंग टू सेल्स इज 3 वोल्टेज. सो इट इज़ वेरी इंपॉर्टेंट, इट इज वेरी इंपॉर्टेंट लाइन्स आर हेयर दैट द वोल्टेज प्रोवाइडेड बाय द वन सेल, हाउ मेनी वोल्टेज प्रोवाइडेड बाय द वन सेल. सो आवर आंसर इज हेयर 1.5 वोल्टेज प्रोवाइडेड बाय द वन सेल एंड द वोल्टेज दैट आर प्रोवाइडेड बाय द हैविंग बैटरी हैविंग द टू सेल्स इज प्रोवाइड द 3 वोल्टेज. बैटरी इज यूज इन कार, इन्वर्टर, कैमरा एंड मोबाइल फोन्स आर रिचार्जेबल बैटरीज. सो गाइस दीज आर द बैटरीज दैट आर यूज इन द कार, इन्वर्टर, कैमरा और मोबाइल फोन्स. दिस टाइप ऑफ बैटरी आर कॉल्ड रिचार्जेबल बैटरी. नाउ वी हैव डिस्कस्ड द वंडर बॉक्स. नाउ सेल और अ बैटरी. सेल इज अ पोर्टेबल सोर्स ऑफ इलेक्ट्रिक करंट विच हैज टू टर्मिनल्स, अ पॉजिटिव एंड अ नेगेटिव. सो एज सेल, वॉट इज सेल? द सेल इट इज अ पोर्टेबल सोर्स ऑफ द इलेक्ट्रिक करंट एंड आवर सेल इट इज हैविंग द टू टर्मिनल्स, फर्स्ट इज पॉजिटिव प्लस एंड अ नेगेटिव माइनस. वैन इट इज कनेक्टेड टू अ सर्किट, करंट फ्लोज थ्रू द पॉजिटिव एंड ऑफ द सेल टू द नेगेटिव एंड ऑफ द सेल. सो इज वैन वैन दिस वैन वैन द सेल इट इज कनेक्टेड टू द सर्किट, वैन द सेल इट इज कनेक्टेड टू द सर्किट. सो द करंट फ्लोज फ्रॉम द पॉजिटिव एंड ऑफ द सेल टू द नेगेटिव एंड ऑफ द सेल. नाउ सेल्स आर यूज इन द डिवाइसेज वेयर अ स्मॉल अमाउंट ऑफ करंट इज रिक्वायर्ड, सच एज अ वॉचेस, कैलकुलेटर्स एंड क्लॉक्स. सो नाउ गाइस द सेल्स दैट आर यूज इन द डिवाइसेज वेयर द स्मॉल अमाउंट ऑफ द करंट इज रिक्वायर्ड सच एज द इन द वॉचेस, कैलकुलेटर्स और द क्लॉक्स. सेल कन्वर्ट्स द केमिकल एनर्जी इन टू अ इलेक्ट्रिकली एनर्जी. सो गाइस द सेल इट इज अ पोर्टेबल सोर्स ऑफ द इलेक्ट्रिक करंट एंड इट इज ऑल्सो कन्वर्ट द केमिकल एनर्जी इन टू द इलेक्ट्रिकल एनर्जी. नाउ इट इज अ डायग्राम ऑफ द कार बैटरी. इन सम अप्लायंसेस वेयर मोर करंट इज रिक्वायर्ड वी यूज बैटरी. सो गाइस देयर आर मेनी अप्लायंसेस एंड इन सम ऑफ द अप्लायंसेस द करंट इज रिक्वायर्ड मोर, सो देयर वी यूज द बैटरी. इट इज अ डिवाइस दैट कंसिस्ट ऑफ वन और मोर सेल्स. नाउ इट इज अ डिवाइस इट कंसिस्ट ऑफ द वन और मोर सेल्स इन अ बैटरी. द पॉजिटिव टर्मिनल ऑफ द फर्स्ट सेल इज कनेक्टेड टू द नेगेटिव टर्मिनल ऑफ द सेकेंड सेल. सो नाउ गाइस इन द बैटरी द पॉजिटिव टर्मिनल ऑफ द फर्स्ट सेल इज कनेक्टेड टू द नेगेटिव टर्मिनल ऑफ द सेकेंड सेल. सच अ कॉम्बिनेशन ऑफ टू और मोर सेल्स कनेक्टेड इन सीरीज इज नोन एज अ बैटरी. सो गाइस व्हाट इज बैटरी? बैटरी द कॉम्बिनेशन ऑफ द टू और मोर सेल्स. व्हाट इज बैटरी? द कॉम्बिनेशन ऑफ द टू और मोर सेल्स दैट इज कनेक्टेड इन द सीरीज इट इज नोन एज द बैटरी. बैटरीज आर यूज्ड इन रेडियो, ट्रांसिस्टर्स, टॉर्चेस एंड रिमोट कंट्रोल्ड टॉयज. सो इज बैटरी वेयर द बैटरी इज यूज बैटरी इज यूज इन द कार, इन्वर्टर और अ कैमरा और मोबाइल फोन्स. और बैटरी इज ऑल्सो यूज इन द रेडियोज, ट्रांसिस्टर्स, टॉर्चेस एंड रिमोट कंट्रोल्ड टॉयज. नाउ गाइस लेट्स मूव टू द नेक्स्ट पेज. वी हैव डिस्कस्ड द सेल और अ बैटरी. नाउ वी आर ऑन द नेक्स्ट पेज एंड इट इज़ अ न्यू टॉपिक. इट इज़ अ बल्ब. अ बल्ब इज एन अप्लायंस विच गिव्स आउट लाइट व्हेन इलेक्ट्रिसिटी पासिस थ्रू इट. सो इज बल्ब. बल्ब व्हाट इज बल्ब? इट इज एन अप्लायंस, इट इज एन अप्लायंस दैट गिव्स आउट द लाइट व्हेन द इलेक्ट्रिसिटी पासिस थ्रू इट. इट हैज़ अ थिन वायर कॉल्ड फ्लामेंट विच इज़ मेड अप ऑफ द टंगस्टेन. सो नाउ गाइस, इन द बल्ब इफ यू हैव सीन, सो दैट इट कंसिस्ट ऑफ द थिन वायर एंड दैट थिन वायर इज कॉल्ड द फिलामेंट एंड योर फिलामेंट इज मेड अप ऑफ द टंगस्टेन. वैन करंट पासिस थ्रू द फिलामेंट इट बिकम्स वाइट हॉट एंड इमिट्स लाइट. सो गाइस, when the current passes through the filament, the bulb filament, so it becomes the hot and emits light. If the filament is broken, the circuit becomes incomplete, so the current stops flowing through the circuit, hence the bulb is fused and will not glow. So as this filament is the broken, so the automatically the circuit becomes the incomplete and the current stops flowing through the circuit, so the bulb, your bulb place become the fused or the will not glow. Now next topic, switch or key. What we do if we don't want light from the bulb? So guys, if we don't want the light from the bulb, so what we have to do and what we want to, we use switch and turn it in off position. Switch is a device that connects or break the circuit according to our convenience. So guys, if we don't need the light, so we need how can we get the light? So we use the switch and it is turned in off positions. So the switch, it is a device that connect or break the circuit according to our convenience. At the same time, it is an essential component of the electrical appliances that shapes electrical energy. So at the same time, this switch, it is an essential component of the electrical appliances that shapes our electrical energy. When switch is on position, the circuit is complete and the current flows in the circuit. So as switch, if it is in the on position, so it is complete and the current continuously flowing in the circuit. And when the switch is off position, so the circuit becomes incomplete and the current stops flowing. So as we know that when the switch is off position, so the circuit becomes the incomplete and the current doesn't flow. Next, conducting wires. Mostly metals are good conductors of electricity. Now guys, as we have seen that many metals are there and mostly metals are the good conductors of the electricity. Copper and silver offer very little resistances on passing electric current through them. Although silver is the best conductor of electricity, it is expensive, so we prefer copper and aluminium to manufacture the electrical wires. So guys, the copper or silver, it is having the little resistance on passing the electric current through them. So the silver is the best conductor of the electricity and it is very expensive, so we don't purchase this silver, so we prefer the copper and the aluminium to manufacture the electrical wires. We purchase the copper or the aluminium to manufacture the electrical wires. Now next topic, ammeter and the voltmeter. Now an ammeter is a device which is used to measure the amount of electric current flowing through the circuit. So now guys, ammeter, what is ammeter? If you have seen that the ammeter, it is a device which is used to measure the amount of electric current. It is a device which is used to measure the amount of electric current flowing through a circuit. इट इज कॉल्ड द एमीटर एंड वोल्टमीटर. वोल्टमीटर इज अ डिवाइस विच इज यूज टू मेजर द पोटेंशियल डिफरेंस बिटवीन द टू टर्मिनल्स ऑफ द सर्किट. एंड वॉट इज द रोल ऑफ द वोल्टमीटर. इट इज अ डिवाइस विच इज यूज टू मेजर द पोटेंशियल डिफरेंस बिटवीन द टू टर्मिनल्स ऑफ द सर्किट. नाउ एन इलेक्ट्रिक करंट फ्लोज फ्रॉम द पॉजिटिव टर्मिनल टू द नेगेटिव टर्मिनल ऑफ द बैटरी. एंड द इलेक्ट्रिक करंट, दिस इलेक्ट्रिक करंट इट फ्लोज फ्रॉम द पॉजिटिव टर्मिनल टू द नेगेटिव टर्मिनल ऑफ द बैटरी. द डिफरेंस इन इलेक्ट्रिक पोटेंशियल ऑफ द टू टर्मिनल इज नोन एज द पोटेंशियल डिफरेंस. सो गाइस, व्हाट इज द पोटेंशियल डिफरेंस? इट मीन्स दैट द डिफरेंस इन द इलेक्ट्रिक पोटेंशियल ऑफ द टू टर्मिनल्स. व्हाट द डिफरेंस इन टू इन द डिफरेंस इन इलेक्ट्रिकल पोटेंशियल ऑफ द टू टर्मिनल्स इज नोन एज द पोटेंशियल डिफरेंस. नाउ वी हैव डिस्कस्ड द बल्ब, स्विच और की और कंडक्टिंग वायर्स और द एमीटर एंड द वोल्टमीटर. नाउ लेट्स मूव टू द न्यू टॉपिक. नाउ गाइस, वी ऑन द न्यू टॉपिक, इफेक्ट्स ऑफ इलेक्ट्रिक करंट. नाउ गाइस, फर्स्ट ऑल आई वांट टू शो यू द सिंबल्स ऑफ द कंपोनेंट्स इन द इलेक्ट्रिक सर्किट. सो गाइस, दीज आर द नेम ऑफ द कंपोनेंट्स एंड दीज आर द सिंबल्स ऑफ दैट कंपोनेंट. लाइक फर्स्ट कंपोनेंट इज सेल. नाउ गाइस, सेल इट इज हैविंग द सिंबल लाइक दैट. सेल इज हैविंग द टू टर्मिनल्स ना, पॉजिटिव और नेगेटिव. सो लाइक दैट सिंबल इज दैट. एंड बैटरी इट इज हैविंग द लाइक सिंबल. And switch off, it is having the this symbol like the circuit is broken. And the switch on, it is having the like that symbol. And it is a bulb symbol, it is a voltmeter symbol, and it is the ammeter symbol. Now, effects of electric current. The energy stored in electric current is called electrical energy. So guys, the energy which is stored in the electric current is called the electrical energy. This electrical energy is converted into different forms of energy such as heat energy, mechanical energy and sound energy. So guys, this electrical energy is converted into the different forms of the energy such as the heat energy, mechanical energy and the sound energy. It can produce different effects of electric current. Now guys, it can also produce the different types of the and different effects of the electric current. Current can be calculated using formula. Current is equal to charge upon time. Now guys, it is the formula for calculating the current. Current is equal to charge upon time. Now heating effect on electric current. Let us understand the heating effect of current through an activity. Now guys, we are going to conduct an activity for heating effect of electric current through this activity. Now it is the activity first. Construct an electric circuit using a wire, a switch, a cell and a bulb. So guys, for doing this activity, we have to construct a electric circuit using a wire, switch, cell or the bulb. With the help of using this component, we can construct the electric circuit. So guys, for making the electric circuit, we need wire, switch, cell or the bulb. Keep the switch in off position and touch the bulb. Now guys, then we have to switch off the position and then touch the bulb. The bulb is not warm. Then press the switch to on position and after a minute touch the bulb again. Then guys, what we have to do? We have to press the switch in the on positions and then we have to after some time we have to check or touch the bulb again. You will find that the bulb becomes hot. So as after doing this, what we will observe? We will observe that the bulb, it becomes the hot after the switch to on position. This indicates that the heat is produced on passing electric current through the bulb. So as this indicates that the heat which is produced on the passing electric current through the bulb. Now guys, let's move to the next page. Now guys, we are on the new page. After completing the activity for heating effect of the electric current. Now guys, we are on the new topic. When current flows through a metallic wire, the wire offers some resistance to the flow of electrons. So now guys, when the current flows through the metallic wire, so the wires, it offers some resistance to flow of electrons. During this process, electric energy converts into heat energy. Now guys, during this process, so the electric energy, it is converted into the heat energy. This was first observed by James Prescott Joule. Later, this was called as the Joule's law of heating effect. Now guys, this is first observed by the James Prescott Joule. And later, this was called as the Joule's laws of the heating effect. The heat produced depends on the amount of resistance offered by the wire. Now guys, the heat is produced depends on the amount of resistance offered by the wire. Copper wire generally offers very low resistance and doesn't get heated much. Now guys, this copper wire, it generally offers very low resistance and it can't or it doesn't get heated much. On the other hand, a thin wire of tungsten or aluminium offers high resistance and gets heated up quickly. Now guys, on the other hand, a thin wire of the tungsten or the aluminium, it offers high resistance and it gets heated up quickly. This is the reason behind the uses of tungsten wire as the filament of bulbs. So now guys, it is the reason behind the uses of the tungsten wire as the filament of bulbs. When a bulb is switched on, current flows through the filament, the heated up the wire and it glows. So now guys, when the bulb, it is on the switch position, so the current flows through the filament, the heats up the wire and it glows. Here you can see guys, the glowing through bulb, glowing flowing of an electric current. So guys, first of all, the heat transfer into this filament, and through the current flows through the filament, the heats up and the wire and it glows. Some appliances such as the electric heater, electric immersion rod, electric toaster, electric iron also using this property of heating due to the flow of electric current. So now guys, these are the appliances like the electric heater, electric immersion and electric toaster. These are the in this such type of the appliances, this property is also used of heating due to the flow of the electric current. They have bound coils of wire known as a heating element through which current flows, resulting in its heating due to resistance offered by the wire. So now guys, this type of appliances have bound coils of the wire which is known as a heating element, and through this the current flows and the resulting in its heating due to the resistance which is offered by the wire. Now the heating effect of current depends on the following factors. Now guys, the heating effect of the current, these are depending on the many factors, and these are the factors that given in point wise. First factor is cross sectional area. सेकेंड पॉइंट टाइम एंड थर्ड पॉइंट करंट. सो नाउ फर्स्ट पॉइंट क्रॉस सेक्शनल एरिया. थिनर द वायर मोर इज द हीटिंग अफेक्ट एंड विस वर्सा. सो नाउ वाइज क्रॉस सेक्शनल एरिया इट इज़ द थिनर वायर एंड इट इज मोर इज द अफेक्टिंग अफेक्ट एंड विस वर्सा. सेकेंड टाइम लार्जर द टाइम फॉर विच द करंट फॉर विच द इलेक्ट्रिक करंट फ्लोज एंड मोर इज द हीटिंग अफेक्ट. सो वाइज वॉट इज द रोल ऑफ द टाइम. इट मीन्स दैट द लार्जर टाइम फॉर विच द इलेक्ट्रिक करंट फ्लोज और मोर इज द हीटिंग अफेक्ट. थर्ड करंट ग्रेटर द मैग्नीट्यूड ऑफ अ करंट मोर इज द हीटिंग अफेक्ट. सो वॉट इट मीन्स द करंट मीन्स दैट ग्रेटर द मैग्नीट्यूड ऑफ द करंट एंड मोर इज द हीटिंग अफेक्ट. नाउ नेक्स्ट इट इज द लास्ट टॉपिक इलेक्ट्रिक फ्यूज. नाउ गाइस हियर यू कैन सी द कार्ट्रिज फ्यूज. सो इफ अ लार्ज अमाउंट ऑफ करंट पासिस थ्रू एन एप्लायंस देन द वायर गेट्स ओवर हीटेड एंड द एप्लायंसेस गेट्स डैमेज्ड. नाउ गाइस हाउ द एप्लायंसेस बिकम द फ्यूज. सो गाइस इट बिकम्स देन व्हेन द लार्ज अमाउंट ऑफ द करंट पासिस थ्रू द एप्लायंस then the wire gets overheated and the appliance gets the damage. Then the appliance has get the damage. To counter such situation, a safety device known as the electric fuse is installed in the circuit. So guys, for counter the such type of the situations, a safety device which is known as the electric fuse, it is installed in the circuit. Now it is the metallic cap and is the fuse wire. It is a glass tube. An electric fuse consists of a wire made up of an alloy of tin and lead with a very low melting point. So now what is the electric fuse? The electric fuse, it consists of the wire. It consists of wire and the wire which is made up of an alloy of tin and lead with the very low melting point. When current passing through the wire exceeds the maximum limit. So now guys, when this current passing through the wire, so it exceeds the maximum limit and it gets up heated. If the temperature of the fuse, now guys, let's move to the next page. Now guys, we on the new page. So last line is that if the temperature of the fuse wire increases its boiling point, then it gets melts and quickly breaks the circuit. So guys, if the temperature of the fuse wire it increases, so its melting point and it gets melt and quickly break the circuit. This prevents damage to the appliances. So guys, only and only it is the reasons and it is prevents the damage to the appliances when the temperature of the fuse wire increases its boiling point. So then it gets melts and quickly breaks the circuit and it prevents the damage to the appliances. A cartridge fuse consists of a fuse wire fitted in a glass tube with its two ends tightly connected to metallic caps. Now as a cartridge fuse, in the last page diagram I have shown you the cartridge fuse. It consists of the fuse wire and it is fitted in the glass tube with the two ends tightly which is connected to the metallic caps. Since cartridge fuse is compact in size, it is used to protect sensitive electronic devices such as the refrigerators, pumps and dryers. So guys, this cartridge fuse, it is compact in size and it is used to protect the sensitive electronic devices such as the refrigerators, pumps and the dryers. Nowadays, another device known as a MCB, miniature circuit breaker, is used in addition to or in place of an electric fuse in household circuits. So guys, Here you can see the nowadays the another device which is known as the MCV. It is the MCV, and all the people is having the MCV in its home. It is the MCV. So MCV, full form of the MCV is miniature circuit breaker, and it is used to it is used in addition to or in a place of the electric fuse in the household circuits. MCV is a switch that automatically trips down if the current flowing through it exceeds the prescribed maximum limit. So this MCV, that all the people are having at home, so this MCV, it is a switch that automatically trips down if the current flowing through it exceeds the prescribed the maximum limit, and thus it prevents damage or fire. Then guys, it prevents damage or the fire. A fuse or MCV protects the circuit in case of a short circuit and overloading of the current. So guys, a fuse or the MCV, it protects the circuit in the case of the short circuit and the overloading of the current. So guys, the MCV plays a very important role in our home, that a fuse or the MCV protects us from the case of the short circuit and the overloading of the current. Now, when too many electrical appliances draw large amount of current at the same time, it is known as overloading. So what is overloading? It means that when too many electricals appliances, they draw the large number of the current at the same time, it is known as the overloading. The large amount of current can heat it up copper wire to such a high temperature that it might catches fire. So guys, the large amount of the current that can heat it up the copper wire and to such a high temperature, it catches fire. Then it catches the fire. Now next topic, magnetic effect of electric current. Now it is a very important topic, the magnetic effect of the electric current. Now guys, there are three effects of the electric current. First is chemical, second is magnetic, and the third is electric. Now guys, the first is here, magnetic effect. Now magnetic effect of current was first discovered by Hans Christian Oersted. Now guys, he was a scientist, the Hans Christian Oersted, he was a scientist, and he was first discovered the magnetic effect of the current. We know that a magnet can attract pieces of iron, nickel and cobalt. Guys, as we know that the magnetic, it can attract the pieces of the iron, nickel and the cobalt. Let us now study how magnet and electricity are related. To show the relationship between the two, let us perform the following activity. Now it is activity 2. Now set up a simple circuit on a table by using a battery, wires and a switch. So guys, first of all, what we have to do, we have to set up the simple circuits on the table by using the battery, wires or a switch. Then keep a magnetic compass near the circuit. Then guys, what we have to do, we have to keep a magnetic compass near the circuit. When we switch on the circuit, the electric current starts flowing through the wires. So guys, when we switch on the circuit, so the electric current, it starts flowing through the wires. It is observed that the needle of the compass gets deflected from its rest positions. So guys, it is observed that the needle of the compass, it gets deflected from its rest position. When we switch the current off, compass needle comes to the rest position again. So guys, when the switch off, when the switch the current off, so the compass needle it comes to the rest position again. Hence, the magnetic effect is related to the electric current. Guys, so we can see that the magnetic effect is related to the electric current after doing this activity. Now guys, let's move to the new topic. Now guys, we are on the new topic. It is electromagnet. Now, take an iron nail and wrap a conducting wire around it as a coil. Then connect to the two ends of the wire to source of electric current and allow current to pass through it. Now guys, a simple electromagnet. So for making this type of the magnet, first of all we have to take the iron nail and wrap it around the conducting wire. Here you can see on this the conducting wire is wrapped and add is a coil. Then we have to connect the two ends of the wire to the source of the electric current, so the allow it allowed the current to pass through it. You will observe that an iron nail behaves like a magnet with its two ends acting a north and a south poles. So guys, after doing this we will observe that an iron nail it behaves like the magnet with its two ends acting as the north or the south poles. If an iron clip is brought near its end, it gets attracted to it. So guys, if the iron clip is brought near its end, so it gets attracted to it. A magnet found by such arrangement is called an electromagnet. So guys, what is electromagnet? Means a magnet which is found such as an arrangement. A magnet which is found such an arrangement is called the electromagnet. An electromagnet acts as a magnet as long as electric current passes through it. Now guys, this electromagnet, it acts as a magnet as long as a electric current passes through it. It loses its magnetism as soon as the current stops flowing. So guys, it loses its magnetism as soon as the current stops flowing. When the current stops flowing, so it loses its magnetism. An electromagnet is also called a temporary magnet. So guys, what is temporary magnet? Means an electromagnet is called the temporary magnet. Magnet that retains its magnetic strength for the longer period of time is called the permanent magnet. So guys, what is permanent magnet? Means a magnet that retains or loses its magnetic strength for the longer period of time is called the permanent magnet. Now guys, let's move to the new page. So guys, I want to share this. It is a solenoid. And on the other page, we learn about that. Now guys, we are on the new page. So the strength of an electromagnet can be increased by the following ways. So guys, these are the ways by which we can increase the strength of the electromagnet. Now, first way is increasing the number of turns of the conducting wires. So guys, first way is that by which the strength of the electromagnet can be increased. So first point is that increasing the number of the turns of the conducting wires. If we increase the conducting wires number, so it can be increase the strength of the electromagnet. And second point, increasing the strength of the current flowing in the circuit. And second way is that the increasing the strength of the current flowing in a circuit. Now guys, we have discussed the ways. A solenoid is a device in which long insulated wire is bound around a hollow metallic core. So is solenoid. It is a device in which a long insulated wire is bound around the hollow metallic core. It is cylindrical in shape. So guys, this device solenoid, it is cylindrically in shape, and a solenoid can be used as an electromagnet. So guys, this solenoid, it is also used or can be used as an electromagnet. Now, uses of electromagnet. Electromagnets are used in many fields. They are used to lift heavy iron articles like cars in the workshop, to separate iron from the garbage dump, and loudspeakers, telephones, electric fans, washing machines, refrigerators, toys, and electric bells. So as this electromagnet has been used in the many fields or for the many purpose, they are used to the lift heavy iron articles like car in the workshop, and to separate iron from the garbage dump, and also used in the loudspeakers, telephones, electric fans, washing machines, toys, and the electric bells. Now, electric bell. Guys, it is an electromagnet, it is a gong, it is a hammer. The switch, here you can see it is a soft iron armature, and it is a battery. Now, we are going to learn about the electric bell. So, all our homes have electric door bells. So guys, as we know that all we have the electric door bells. The doorbell or the electric bell makes use of the principle of an electromagnet. So guys, this doorbell or the electric bell, it makes the uses of the principle of an electromagnet. An electric bell is based on the principle of magnetic effect of current. So guys, This electric bell has been also based on the principle of the magnetic effect of the current. So, a horseshoe type of electromagnet is used in an electric bell which is connected to the source of current through the switch. Now guys, the electromagnet, it is in the shape of the horseshoe type of the shape, and it is used in the electric bell, and this electric bell, it is connected to the source of the current through the switch. Through this switch, guys, you can see through this switch, it is connected to the source of the current. In addition to the electromagnet, the electric bell has a metallic gong, a hammer to strike the gong, and a screw attached to the soft iron scrape armature. So guys, here you can see that the electric bell has a metallic gong. Here you can see it is having the metallic gong or the hammer. This hammer to strike the gong. For striking the gong, it is the hammer. And a screw attached to the iron strip armature. Then it is soft iron and attaches to the armature. When the button is pressed, the circuit becomes complete. So as when any people come to our house and then he press the button, so the circuit becomes complete and the current starts flowing, and thus the electromagnet attracts the iron rod. So the hammer gets attracted to the gong and strikes to the produce a ringing sound. So as what will happen when any person has pressed the button at our home, so the circuit becomes complete and this the current starts flowing and the electromagnetic attracts to the iron rod and the hammer. This, as here you can see, this hammer has gets attracted to the gong and strikes to produce the ringing sound. Now guys, we have discussed the each and every topics of this chapter, and it is our last topic. So guys, if you have any query or questions related to this chapter or related to 7th class science, so you can ask me through the comments, and don't forget to like, subscribe, or press bell icon on our channel for the upcoming videos. Thank you everyone.